This is just going to be a quick video on how to amend a motion. Specifically, we are going to talk about how to amend a main motion. You can amend motions that are not main motions, and it's a very, 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 very similar process. But for the assignment that I gave in class, all you have to do is know how to amend a main motion. So there are four types of amendments. There's really three, and the fourth kind is a combination of two of them. So let's just focus, to start with, on how to structure an amendment. So, as all motions, you always start a motion with the words, I move. I move. That is how you start every motion. And that's how you start amendments. I move to amend. I move to amend, in this case, the main motion. As I said, we're going to be talking about the main motion. You can amend other motions, in which case you would say what motion you're amending, but again, we're focusing on that main motion because that's what we're learning. So I move to amend the main motion. I move to amend the main motion by. I'm going to write those dots bigger. And that's where those three, four-ish ways that you can amend a motion come in. So I move to amend the main motion by. The first way you can amend the main motion is by adding. And when you amend the main motion by adding, you are always adding to the end. So, for example, if the main motion was to have a pizza party and you wanted to amend it by adding, nope, just kidding, that one doesn't work. Oh wait, no, just kidding. Okay, we got it, I'm here. And you wanted to amend it by adding the words on Friday, you would say, I move to amend the main motion by adding the words on Friday. There's a little bit more that we have to add to the end, but that would be adding. Then there is also inserting. And when you insert as an amendment, you are putting words in the middle. So again, let's use our pizza party example. If you were to have the main motion to have a pizza party and you wanted it to be and ice cream, you would say, I move to amend the main motion by inserting the words and ice cream between pizza and party. And that's inserting. Strike out is our third one. And what it sounds like is exactly what it is. Hello. Strike out is exactly what it sounds like. You're getting rid of something. So if you wanted to get rid of the word pizza and just have a party, you would say, I move to amend the main motion by striking out the word pizza. Then our last one is that combination one. It is striking out and inserting. So just as it sounds, it is a combination of strike out and insert. So you're going to get rid of something and insert something back in. For example, I move to amend the main motion by striking out the word pizza and inserting ice cream. Now, this is the important part that a lot of people forget. Really important how you end the motion amend is by saying, so if passed, I'm going to run out of room on this board, aren't I? We're going to make it work. Can you see the whole board? There we go. So if passed, the main motion will read, and you are going to say exactly how you want it to read after you amend it. So for example, if you were adding the on Friday to our pizza party motion, I move to amend the main motion by adding the words on Friday. So if passed would read that we have a pizza party on Friday. If you wanted to insert, you could say, I move to amend the main motion by inserting the words I move to amend the main motion by inserting the words and ice cream between pizza and party. So if passed, the main motion would read that we have a pizza and ice cream party. If you wanted to amend by striking out, you would say, I move to amend the main motion by striking out the word pizza. So if passed, the main motion would read that we have a party. And then strike out and insert could be, I move to amend the main motion by striking out the word pizza and inserting the word ice cream. So if passed, the main motion would read that we have an ice cream party. And that is how you want to structure your amendments. I hope that helps. If you still have any questions, feel free to email me. Have a great day.